The top 25 Excel shortcut tips and tricks. These are not ordinary shortcuts. Here are some surprising shortcut tips and tricks that can save you a bunch of time in Excel. Number 1, paste values. This is the quickest method to pasting values. Highlight the area you want to copy, hit Ctrl-C, go to your new location, right-click, and push V. It's that simple. Number 2, insert selection. Select an area of your spreadsheet, go to the edge, and hold the Shift key down while you click on the left mouse button. Drag it to a new location and let go. That inserts the selection in that new location. You can do it for an entire row, or you can do it for an entire column. Number 3, copy selection. You can also do something similar to that by copying the selection. Highlight a selection, go to the corner, hold down the Ctrl key while you left click, and drag and drop it to copy that selection to the new location. Number 4, show formulas. You can toggle the formulas on and off in your spreadsheet by hitting the Ctrl grave accent. That's on the key with the tilde. And it gives you a way to view the formulas being used within your spreadsheet. Number 5, flash fill. You can easily replicate patterns of data with Ctrl-E. Let's say we wanted to take the first name and the type and put it into this column E. If we fill out the first one and hit enter, you can just press Ctrl-E and it will copy the remaining patterns down the list. Number 6, quick sum. If you want to quickly sum up a list of numbers, click on your location where you want the total, hit Alt equals, and enter. There's your sum. Number 7, insert date or time. Click on a cell, hit Ctrl semicolon to insert the date. Hit Ctrl Shift semicolon to insert the time. Number 8, zoom in or out. You can zoom in and out on your spreadsheet by holding down the Ctrl key and using the mouse wheel. You can do the same thing by holding Ctrl Alt and hitting plus or minus. Number 9, auto-size columns and rows. You can automatically resize the width of the columns and the height of the rows to match the data. Just click in the upper left corner to select all your data in your spreadsheet. Double-click on the line between a column, and it adjusts the width of all the columns. Double-click between the rows, and it adjusts the height of all the rows. Number 10, select column or row. Click anywhere in your spreadsheet and hit Ctrl-Spacebar to select the column. Shift-Spacebar to select the row. You can do the same thing by clicking on the column header up here, or the row header. Number 11, create chart. Select a set of data and hit Alt F1 to create a chart. You can hit F11 and it creates the chart on a separate worksheet. Number 12, cell references. If you have a formula, you can click anywhere inside of the cell reference and hit F4 to rotate between column, row, cell referencing. Highlight an entire formula and it changes all the references. Number 13, add notes. If you want to add notes to a cell, just click on it and hit Shift F2. Type in your notes, and they're stored with that cell. Come back there and it displays them. If you right-click, you can delete the note. Number 14, hide column or row. You can quickly hide a row by hitting Ctrl-9. Hide a column with Ctrl-0. Number 15, filter. Click anywhere in the heading of a table and hit Ctrl-Shift-L. That turns on the filtering. And it does it for all the columns in that table. Hit it again, and it turns them off. If you highlight the columns that you want, it turns it on just for those columns. And again, to turn it off. Number 16, select region. If you want to quickly select a region, just click anywhere inside and hit Ctrl-Shift-Spacebar. Number 17, formatting. You can bring up the formatting cell window by hitting Ctrl-1, but you can also assign these categories of formats directly with the Ctrl-Shift and a key. For example, Ctrl-Shift Grave Accent gives you the general format. Ctrl-Shift-1 is the number format. Ctrl-Shift-2 is the time. Ctrl-Shift-3 is the date. Ctrl-Shift-4 is dollar formatting. Ctrl-Shift-5 is percent. Ctrl-Shift-6 is scientific. Number 18, copy down or right. If you want to copy data down from the cell above it, hit Ctrl-D. This also works by highlighting a whole range. If you want to copy to the right, hit Ctrl-R, and it works across a range as well. Number 19, table. If you want to name a table, just highlight your range, hit Ctrl-T. Hit OK on the selection, and you can change the name right here. Number 20, apply or remove border. You can add a border to a group of cells. Just highlight them and hit Ctrl-Shift-7. That adds a border. Ctrl-Shift-minus removes the border. Number 21, workbook statistics. From anywhere on your screen, you can hit Ctrl-Shift-G to bring up statistics about your workbook. It includes the number of tables and formulas and the total number of cells with data in them. Number 22, expand selection. If you want to expand the area you have selected, hit Ctrl-Shift-right arrow or Ctrl-Shift-down arrow, and it'll expand until the next gap in data. Number 23, insert multiple rows. Start on the row that you want to insert above, select multiple rows, in this case 4, right-click, choose Insert, and it inserts 4 rows. Same thing works with columns. Number 24, see formula results. While you're inside of a cell with a formula, you can highlight a portion of the formula, hit F9, and it gives you the results of that calculation. If you hit Ctrl-Z, it reverts it back. I can select the entire formula, hit F9, and get the entire result. Ctrl-Z reverts it back. Number 25, quick analysis. If you highlight a table of data, in the bottom right corner is a quick analysis tool. If it's not there, you can hit Ctrl-Q and it'll come up. Here you can select all kinds of different settings for formatting, creating charts, adding totals, converting your data into tables, and adding sparklines. That's the top 25 Excel shortcut tips and tricks. Start using them today to improve your efficiency using Excel.
Hey, if you want to see more videos like this one, please subscribe. And if you've enjoyed this video, be sure to click the thumbs up and leave a comment. I really do appreciate your support.